Hello, y'all. Welcome to another episodic installation of Above It All. And boy, oh boy, do we have a fucking doozy here. So I'm just going to get right into it. Let's play the freaking clip.
Nature of this. And please, to our viewers, please excuse the graphic nature of this, but I want to make sure that there is no question as to what we're talking about. She says in 1993, Mr. Vice President, that you pinned her against the wall and reached under her clothing and penetrated her with your fingers.
Look at the fucking... Can we get Joy Reid to have a body language expert on here? Look at the way he just shakes his head. It's like, no. No.
Pinned her against the wall and reached under her clothing and penetrated her with your fingers. Would you please go on the record with the American people? Did you sexually assault Tara Reid?
No, it is not true. I'm saying unequivocally, it never happened. And it didn't. It never happened.
Why does he say it? Like, it's just bizarre the way he says it. But there's more clips here.
The New York Times has investigated this exhaustively. They didn't find any of your former staff members were able to corroborate the details of this allegation. She did file a police report a few weeks ago with the D.C. police. But since you want to set the record straight, why limit this only to Tara Reid? Why not release any complaints that it may had been made against you during your Senate career?
I'm prepared to do that. The best of my knowledge, there's been no complaints made against me.
He says he's prepared to do that, except he can, at any point, just release all of his Senate documents, and then we can actually see all the things. But he said he's prepared to do it. But is he actually? I don't know. I don't know.
In terms of my Senate career, in terms of my office, and anything's been run. Look, this is
just look at the way he rambles.
To my knowledge, there's been no complaints made against me in terms of my Senate career, in terms of my office, and anything's been run. Look, this is an open book. There's nothing for me to hide. Nothing at all.
It's so cringy. This is the thing. Is like he's documented lying dozens and dozens of times. Why would he not lie about this? This is the most consequential moment where, if you're a confirmed liar and he's on the record lying literally hundreds of times, why wouldn't he lie about this? Like, why wouldn't he? There's the article here. But it's like, it's just one of those situations where I don't believe him whatsoever. Like, he said he got arrested protesting apartheid in South Africa, and then his campaign had to come out and say, like, yeah, sorry, this isn't true. And then he kept doing it, and then they had to, like, go, like, Biden, please, stop lying. And then if you remember the Biden-Bernie debate where he lied about his record on Social Security, he lied about Bernie having super PACs, he lied about all this fucking stupid garbage. For no reason, by the way. There's no reason to lie about the super PACs. There's no reason to lie about apartheid South Africa stuff. All he did was give himself the shadow of having no credibility, and now he's going to say this, that he did not do anything to Tara Reid? I'm sorry, buddy. I don't fucking buy it. I'm sorry, Jack. Get your words straight, fat. Like, I'm sorry. Like, it's just, I don't believe you. I just don't believe you. It's not true. It's factually just, you know, there's, okay, so I will have the obvious stipulation. There's no way to know. There's no, unless we develop some device that lets us peer into the fucking annals of history, there is no way to know whether or not this actually happened. However, given all the contemporaneous accounts, given the Larry King tape of her mother calling about it, given the fact that her neighbor has actually said, yeah, this actually, she told me about this, given the fact that she filed a police report, given the fact that he's not actually releasing his Senate documents, even though he said he would several times, but he's not going to. So these all basically say he's a liar. He's also, of course, lied his entire career. So, like, why would anyone take his word here? This is bizarre. This is pure gaslighting by the mainstream media. And really, I mean, it's we're going to lose this fucking election. And by we, I mean the people, because we've already lost this election. Our only chance at any, like, actual change was Bernie Sanders. And they fucking cheated him out of the primary. Oops. We should just get rid of primaries, honestly. Like, just get rid of primaries, get rid of parties, and just have everyone start running in 2020 until the end of it. That's my opinion. But Jesus Christ, though, this is just an absolute and utter disaster. And that's the thing, is he waited so long to talk about this. Like, we were talking about this in February, and he waited so goddamn fucking long to talk about this. And that's where you really see that he's a liar. If he actually didn't do this, and he was shocked that people would claim he did, he would just say right away, as soon as possible, before the police report was filed and all this stuff, he would have said, "Oh, what? No, I haven't done this." He would offer to meet with Tara Reid. He would offer to, like, what, talk things out. He would do all that, but he's not. He's stayed silent for multiple months. Multiple months. His people that work for his campaign, his senior advisor, Anita Dunn, works for the, I think it was SKD Knickerbocker, who is funded and also funds the Time's Up Legal Defense Fund that Tara Reid tried to go to. And they basically said, "Sorry, we can't do it. It's Biden. He's too big." Even though our entire organization is based on the fact that no man is too big to get exposed for being a rapist or a sexual abuser, even though that's our entire fucking. That's what we base everything around. They said, "Nope, sorry, can't do it for Biden. Just can't do it." So why did all these things happen? These things aren't the details of an honest man. I'm sorry, they're just not. He is a fucking rapist. That is, like, as far as I'm concerned, it's factual. Like, you can call me a conspiracy nut. I don't give a shit. All the information goes down to this conclusion. If you can point to anything, Tara Reid said that Putin wasn't actually that bad once. Oh no, she's a Russian asset. It's unbelievable. Here's the thing. I'm gonna say this right now. If Joe Biden makes it until November, I will vote for the Democratic nominee, regardless of who it is. I live in North Carolina, so that's my decision, okay? Now, I will say this. I do not blame anyone if they say they won't vote for Joe Biden. Because look at him. Look at him. I'm voting from a place of defense. I don't want my life to be cut short because of the Trump administration, which, who knows? I mean, 4 more years of that fucking shit, anything is possible. So I don't want that. I'd rather like they did in France, oppose Macron from day one. I would rather do that with Biden. He is a weak, a frail, and a dying, both literally and also in the sense of the neoliberal project. It's not that great. This isn't Bill Clinton's administration. He doesn't have a mandate. Even if he barely squeaks by, which it's totally possible he squeaks by. It's impossible he has a landslide. That's not happening. And it's very possible that he loses. But if he squeaks by, he's not going to have any sort of mandate, and he's going to be a weak, frail opponent. Who knows? Nancy Pelosi might not even be there in 2021. So again, this is a situation where we're dealing with someone who can't be trusted, but at the same time, look how weak he is. If you are someone who's in opposition to the government, I would, again, I say this as someone who hates the government. I am a communist, okay? I don't like the government whatsoever, especially the United States government. So I say this as if we're going to have an enemy in the White House, if someone in the White House is going to exist and he is going to be the idol that we go after and attack, the talisman or so, to display the failures of government, I would much rather it be Biden, stumbling, lying dog face pony soldier motherfucker, than fucking Donald Trump, who just is, he's, I'm sorry, he's scary. He's a fucking horrifying figure. And that's just my opinion. That being said, of course, anyone who's a centrist who says Joe Biden is innocent and that's why you should vote for him, you are a piece of garbage. Again, I can articulate a strategic, tactical defense of voting for the Democrat nominee, but I cannot, in good conscience, lie about it. I can't. I won't, because I'm a normal person. I've been assaulted sexually. It's not fun. You don't want to go through this situation. So to see someone like this, even after the whole 2016, like 2017 Me Too fucking feminist fucking cringe marches, right? Even after all of that fucking garbage, this is what we end up with. And if you want to go ahead and say he didn't do it, you're a piece of garbage. If you want to say he did do it, and you want to retain your credibility and just articulate a tactical defense of voting for the Democrat over Trump, that's fine. You know, that's at least you're being honest. That's what I'm doing. But I can't say that he didn't do this, because he did do this. Every sign in the history of his entire career points to this. He sniffs the hair of little children, for God's sakes. Like, this is not a fucking This is he was referred to as handsy Uncle Joe up until this presidential run. That's how we fucking referred to him. We being people in, like, you know, the progressive online space. We've, like, it's been obvious that he, like, he's literally documented on television, like, grabbing little girls' chests, like, ooh, like, he does this on live television, and you're gonna tell me that rape is just, oh, it's outside of his purview. I'm sorry, I don't buy it. Go fuck yourself.